Part 2. Verdant Wind. Garland Moon. The Chaos of War. Claude's plan to call in all Myron forces succeeds, and the Alliance Army captures Fort Mercius. Before they can celebrate their victory, javelins of light rain down from the sky and destroy the fort. Forced to temporarily evacuate, the Alliance Army regroups at Garrig Mach until it is ready to march on Enbar, the Imperial capital.
It's almost time to invade the Imperial capital. We still don't know where Rhea is, but if she's alive, she's likely in Enbar. Hopefully we manage to find her without too much trouble. I know, but if we're not careful, she'll just be whisked away again. I'm sure you must be anxious to see her again. I understand. You need to see Rhea again so you can figure out who you really are. But we're going up against Edelgard here. It won't be so simple.
Our next stop is the Imperial capital. We've sure come a long way.
What are you talking about? This is Garrig Mach. It's where we started.
I didn't mean literally, Raphael. I was speaking symbolically.
My earnest desire to protect the Alliance has carried me this far. It will not fail me. I am sure the rest of you all have your own reasons to fight as well. Of course, I understand that the fight will not end until we defeat the Empire. And now the time has arrived at long last to march on the Imperial capital and defeat the Emperor.
It really gets you thinking, doesn't it? We all come from different places and have different goals and dreams. But thanks to those two, we were all able to come together and overcome all sorts of challenges.
You are referring to Claude and the Professor, I assume? Even within our own odd group, those two are particularly unusual.
Oh, so you are aware that you're odd.
Well, it was simply a figure of speech. I am speaking about Claude and the Professor right now.
They're like the wind in the trees.
Huh? Claude and the Professor are? What does that even mean? And who is which?
I was just thinking that if we're the birds, then those two are like the trees and the wind. The Professor is a great tree that kindly embraces us and watches over us as we perch on its branches. And Claude is like the wind, pushing us forward as we soar across the open sky.
The metaphor about the Professor is solid, but I think Claude just blows us around on a whim. Still, we owe him a lot.
I think that's beautiful, Marianne. I can really picture it. When this war is over, I'd love to paint a picture of those two. Oh, and of all the people we've fought with as well.
You mean like a historical painting? I like that. Maybe our descendants will look at it a long, long time from now.
I must say, that piques my interest. I look forward to seeing how you portray my valiant efforts.
When you put it that way, we may be witnessing one of the greatest events in Fodlan's history. It's a lot of pressure, but the sense of duty I feel is even stronger than the fear.
I'm just happy to be here with all you. I won't get scared, no matter what we face.
We have our goal. Enbar, the Imperial capital. Let's get to work.
Hey, sorry for the wait, Professor.
Thank you so much. Ah, delicious. Yeah. I feel like you can see right through me. Oh, I can really have this? Something wrong with my face? A bruise on my cheek? Nah, Professor, everything's fine. What a wonderful aroma. Professor, you are... Is it rude to say you're a mysterious person? Because you are. Mysterious. Hmm? In a time... time like this, not a lot of people can keep their hands clean. Thank you for the treat, Professor. I'd like to do this again sometime.
As my mind clings to desperate thoughts, here it comes, horsebow moon and summer's end.
Did you hear me just now? What did you think?
Marvelous, as though sung by the goddess herself. Enchanting, heart-rending, your voice truly captivates all who hear. It is as though you channel all the emotion and human experience of your life into the music.
Well, I guess I have my fair share of life experience, so long as you're not implying I'm old.
No, that is not... I mean to say that you skillfully applied your own interpretation in the music.
Interpretation? When I sing, I am not interpreting. I'm scarcely thinking at all. I simply... yield my heart to the poetry, and the emotion follows naturally.
I believe that is what they call genius. I hope you will permit me to listen again. I would like to hear it up close next time.
Of course. Next time I'll perform a private show. Just the two of us.
You mock me.
Never. I wasn't mocking you. In fact, I'd like to see some more of your poetry.
My poetry? Why?
I'd like to use it for another song. I promise that when it's done, you'll be the first to hear.
Please, my poetry is merely an idle pursuit.
That doesn't matter. The words are unadorned, the feelings so direct. Your poems have touched my heart. They are so true to life.
I suppose there is a certain appeal in the portrayal of such dark emotions. Even if it is a bit graceless. Very well. Take this. You may use any of the poems I've finished working on.
Oh my, I can hardly wait. Is this the next part of the poem I was singing just now?
Yes. I wrote that after I heard you sing the first part. I had nearly given up on it, to be honest.
but your music gave me the inspiration to continue. Though it is still quite unpolished, and not at all ready for a broader readership, I feel.
Unpolished? No, Lawrence. It's beautiful. Thank you. To think that my voice inspired you. Yet, it's you who inspires my voice. I'm so excited to start a new song.
Yes, please do.
Hi, Raphael. Lovely weather today, isn't it?
Sure is. Staring up at the sky on a clear day always reminds me of my hometown.
What was it like there?
Let's see. Well, it's a real calm and peaceful place. Big, clear skies, too. Just like this. It's full of friendly people and delicious food. Talking about it makes me want to go back.
Yeah, it's a shame we're stuck fighting in this war.
Right? I wonder what my little sis is up to. She's probably grown so much by now. I haven't seen her since I came back to Garrick Mach. She probably wouldn't even recognize me anymore.
I'll bet she would. How could she possibly forget such a terrified... such a terrific big brother? There's no way.
You really think so? That's a relief. All this relief's making me hungry. Want to head to the dining hall?
Oh, actually, we can eat here. I cooked something up for us today.
Oh yeah? I won't say no to that.
I heard you really like meat, so, here you go. It's my first time cooking something like this. I can at least guarantee it isn't poisoned.
Meat? That's my favorite! I'd probably eat it even if it was poisoned.
Is it, good?
That was amazing!
Really? You like it?
So tender, so juicy, so full of flavor. It was practically falling off the bone! The flavor was so rich and sweet! Wait, how can meat be sweet?
Is sweet bad? I thought it was pretty tasty myself.
No. It was delicious. I couldn't believe it. I'd eat more fruits and vegetables if they were this good. If all food tasted like this, I just don't know what I'd do with myself.
Well, if you like it, I wouldn't mind, making more. Whenever you want, really.
Really? That would be great. We gotta get this war over with so you can have more time to cook.
You know, I'd actually like that.
To put it plainly, no, I do not dislike you.
Really? Oh, I'm so glad I asked.
So he does care. Why were you asking me about the world outside Fodlan before?
There's so much I have yet to see. Even these days, when it's ravaged by conflict, the world is so diverse. Buildings and landscapes and geography differ vastly from place to place. There's so much variety within Fodlan. And the outside world must be even more varied. I feel so inspired just thinking about it. So, I'd like to travel there someday.
I see. You should go.
You think so?
I told you before, in order to know the world, you have to experience it for yourself. There is much to see. Even simple things. Flowers, food, varieties that don't exist in Fodlan. New smells, new tastes. I could tell you about them, but you would only imagine them, not comprehend them. If you want true understanding, go out into the world. See it with your eyes, feel it with your skin. Speak to its people. Then you will know.
Yes, perhaps so.
Is there something else?
You've never talked to me like this before, Shamir.
It's nothing.
Sorry.
Hearing you talk about exploring the world made me think about what I should do with myself.
Do you have plans for the future? After the war?
Not yet. You're ahead of me there. I must find my own path.
Ahead of you, Shamir? I highly doubt that.
If you have time for empty compliments, you have time to encourage me instead.
Yes, of course. Shamir, may you find success in everything you do.
Thank you, Ignatz. I'll do my best.
Oh, is that Sedith? Wow, he looks really deep in thought. I wonder what he's writing. A secret diary, maybe?
That phrase doesn't quite work, does it? Let's see about an alternative.
Too uncertain for a diary. Maybe it's a letter. Or a poem.
No, that's bound to introduce misunderstanding. Precision is the key.
It must be really important if he's putting that much thought into every word.
But I mustn't overcomplicate things either. Parting words ought to be precise.
Parting? It's a farewell letter? Is he writing his resignation? Sedith can be a little scary sometimes, but I hope he doesn't leave. It'd be sad to see him go. He shouldn't make such rash decisions. If he's unhappy about something, he should tell someone.
Come now. Do you really think I would resign?
You heard all that?
If you don't wish to be heard talking to yourself, then you should not speak so loudly. I'm sorry to hear that you find me intimidating.
I'm sorry! I won't disturb you ever again!
Wait, Bernadetta! Ugh. Typical behavior for the girl. Most concerning. Can she really go through life this way?
We'll protect you with our lives.
Here's an idea.
Cornelia took control of the kingdom capital and then founded the Fargus Dukedom in the old kingdom territory. Still, Fargus has remained a mere spectator with regard to our actions so far. It's not so surprising when you consider that they can't even get a handle on the Fraldarius territories.
I need to be speaking.
5 years ago, Edelgard said a thing to me. Bridget is a vassal of the Empire. But she also said I always have the freedom to be choosing whether I am with or not with her. I will become the ruler of Bridget. So she said I must make my own path. So now, my path and her path will be colliding.
The Death Knight is no ordinary knight. I will prey upon him. I will quench my blade's thirst with his blood. His focus is on fighting you, I'm sure. But mine will be the last face he sees.
They used to call Inbar the City of Saros. To assault it together with the knights is surreal. If Saros were alive today, I wonder what she might make of our war. In Inbar, there was once a southern church, and apparently a bishop was dispatched to it. 100 years ago, the southern church became entangled in an insurrection. Until 5 years ago, the Empire and the church maintained a certain distance from one another.
City. I don't have many good memories of her, if I'm being honest, but she's dearer to me than my father. If you happen to see her, please make sure she's not caught up in all the fighting. She's only a civil servant, so hopefully she takes a cue from her Bernie and stays inside.
Well, if we can win this war, then Claude will be the king of Fodlan, and maybe he'll tear down the wall that separates Fodlan from the outside world. I know it's hard to imagine, but I really hope he does. It would be so much better if people could live together instead of apart. I might even be able to live an ordinary life in the world Claude envisions.
Nardel guy, or Nadir, I suppose. It was all some trick, and we fell for it. I don't think the nickname the Undefeated applies if he flees from us. Though, maybe he only got that name by running away. Can't be defeated if you run off, right?
Came and went all the time, but the people behind the scenes would stay forever. I'll bet I'd know a few of them now, even after all these years. They've probably left the capital by now, although I'm still worried about them.
Just recently, the fish in the pond suddenly started thrashing around like mad. I didn't know what was going on. Then I saw something gleaming in the southeastern sky. It happened right when you were out on campaign. I wonder what it could have been.
We're heading up to Embar next. I hope I make it back safe, so I can tell my little sis about it.
I hear they got a neat opera house there, where Manuela used to perform. What was it called again?
Ah, that's the one. My little sis always goes on about how much she'd like to see him perform. I know we can't see a show, but do you think we could at least see the building?
Professor, nothing to report. Momentum's really picking up for this final battle, huh? Even I'm starting to feel tense. Me! Enbar's history goes back 1400 years. That even predates the founding of the Empire. It's one of the sacred sites of the Saros faith, so it's a pretty big deal. But hey, no need to worry about the monastery while you're fighting the final battle. I've got it covered. I'll defend it to my last.
Professor! Hey there! Is this it? There you go! Is this it? There you go. Come back anytime.
Well, I'll be.
Professor?
Here we are, facing the final battle with the Empire. It's been a long, difficult struggle. We have to get Lady Rhea back, and we have to crush the Empire in the name of Captain Geralt. I don't know what comes next, but we can sort out those details later. Professor.
Yeah. Reinforcements from the Alliance are still incoming. Perhaps we can wait. At least until we have an even balance of power. Plenty of supplies have made it through from the Eastern Church and the Merchants Association in the Alliance. All the people of the Alliance believe we can win, so they're doing everything they can to support us. That means we have to do our best to live up to their expectations.
Professor!
Speaking of which, it's been so long since I've been to the Imperial Capital. I used to go to the opera there with my mother and brother. I never thought my return would be like this.
Okay?
My friend, the reinforcements the Lord sent are finally gathering. Truth be told, Fort Mercius would have made for a better base of operation. But that weird pillar of light changes things. It's pretty scary, honestly. I wonder what it is. It makes sense, but whatever it was, I've never seen destructive power quite like it. I wonder where it came from. Well, I guess pondering it is a waste of energy for now. Let's just get ready to move out. The capital is Edelgard's domain, so she has the advantage. It's going to be a tough battle.
Oh my. With the Empire destroyed, the borders within Fodlan will likely become a thing of the past. With that, the rules of trade will change. Personally, I'm excited to see what these changes will bring.
Hello there.
Of course, the Alliance is making sure that the five great lords help with the effort, but we'll be getting support from the smaller territories too. I'll bet this is the first time those territories have worked so closely together, at least since the founding of the Alliance.
Once this battle is over, what will become of Fargus and Fodlan? My hope is for a world at peace, a world in which this present turmoil is a thing of the past. The stuff of legends. I believe those who survived the atrocities of war have a duty to create a new, better world. So the sooner we can stamp out such turmoil, the better. We must win, Professor. There is no alternative here. I won't allow for anything else.
That's right.
It's such a relief that we've made it this far without having to fight my father. Hey, don't try and scare me. If he turns up as a reinforcement during the assault, we might lose. I'd better make my peace with that.
What?
Hello.
So, Enbar, the capital of the Empire. It's finally time. I never thought I'd live this long. It's like any battle, really. Stay calm, stay focused. Don't give in to the enemy or your own fear. Striking down the Empire is my offering to His Highness. I've left the kingdom. What am I saying?
Years ago, Dagda and Bridget attacked the Empire from the west. Their final target was the capital. But they were countered at a port town long before they reached their destination. I guess our attempt has been more successful than theirs, all things considered.
Looks like we're nearing the end of this struggle. I'm sure Lady Rhea is on tenterhooks waiting for me to swoop in and rescue her. I was just kidding. Pay me no mind. Lady Rhea's not waiting for me, I know. No matter how much I might wish she were. She's waiting for you.
Right.
Here's an idea. The Empire's army should be divided now, with significant troops still in the West. If they don't assert their authority over the Old Kingdom's lords, they'll never know when an uprising might start. Ironically, as soon as we capture the Imperial capital, the Old Kingdom's lords are likely to rise up immediately.
Those things appeared as soon as we got ourselves set up in Fort Mercius. Think what might have happened if they'd have hit us during the battle at Gronder Field, assuming it was the work of the Imperial Army.
Hello there!
Perhaps. Invading the capital and smashing the Empire. I wonder if doing so could really end this war. Care to share your thoughts, Professor? Perhaps you feel similarly to me. The whole mess puts me on edge. Although for now, better to focus my efforts on the fight at hand.
Professor?
We're about to put the finishing touches on this war. I wonder how Fodlan will look without the backdrop of death and destruction. I can't wait to see it. On the other hand, I'm terrified of what the future might hold. Who knows if I'll survive the assault on the capital?
Right. Enbar. Never in my wildest dreams did I imagine I'd be returning like this. Of course, most of the nobles in the Empire make their home in the capital. In the kingdom, all nobles live in their own domains. So if the capital is attacked, it doesn't necessarily affect them directly. What will happen to the Imperial nobles when their capital becomes a battlefield?
Hey, you!
Kinds of rumors about you spreading through the Alliance. Some say you're the new embodiment of Saint Seros herself. Plaud's popularity has certainly risen too. Somewhat.
So, did you know? A magnificent canal flows through downtown Enbar. It's said to have been constructed under the guidance of Saint Seros before the Empire was even formed. Ever since, that canal has been a major lifeline for the capital's development. And now this is how the Empire repays it. Truly, no good deed goes unpunished.
Taught from a young age to believe that the Creed of Seros was just the way of the world. To question it never even occurred to me. But Claude and Edelgard are different. They challenge the common wisdom, even defy it. It is uncomfortable to discard familiar assumptions, but that is an essential quality of the visionary. Indeed, true greatness must lie beyond common sense. That's good. I should write that down.
The whole of the capital is going to be a battleground. The city has such a long heritage. Even so, perhaps it deserves to be reduced to ashes for once. but we can't let the common folk get hurt. We should try to confine the damage to the noble section of town.
Others is a nice change of pace. Usually I do it when I'm alone.
I've never sung a song before, so I don't know if I'm good or bad at it.
Likely that Lady Rhea is confined in the Imperial Palace. If so, then our strategy will be to gain control of the streets and then assault the castle. A street battle followed by a castle invasion. It's just one battle after another. It'll be tough, but we have to win. For Lady Rhea. I was born in Enbar. My mother and father met in a church there. Not too long after, I was brought into the world. I do not understand how war can happen in such a precious place. It is most regrettable.
Professor, at last, the end is nigh. I love the Empire. Part of me wants it to survive, but I know that is not reasonable. The Empire's time has come. What we need now is a mighty leader who can rebuild Fodlan and rule it as a single nation. Nonetheless, it saddens me that we will not have an Adrestian Emperor.
Hi.
Enbar's streets are paved with unhappy memories, Professor. I've avoided the damned place ever since I abandoned my nobility. Swore never to return. Now here we are. To return in this manner. Well, I can't say it is something I ever imagined.
Right, right. Finally going to the capital. This will be my chance to avenge Captain Gerald. Once we smash the Empire, I'm sure his soul will finally be able to rest in peace. Monica killed Captain Gerald for the Flame Emperor, and the Flame Emperor was Edelgard. I know that the future of all Fodlan rests on this battle. Nothing else is more important. But for me, this is personal. For Captain Gerald's sake, I'm going to give it all I've got and more. Wow, this is great! Wow, this is great!
Rhea will be somewhere in the city. I wonder if she can sense us coming. If we are able to save her, then I expect you will learn many secrets that have hitherto been kept from you. Are you prepared for that? Excellent. The battle will soon be upon us. Let us both be at our best for what is to come.
Whenever I think about how we'll be seeing Lady Rhea real soon, I get happy and really get cleaning. We'll get there for sure, right? We'll see her again? I just gotta believe Lady Rhea is waiting for us in the capital. We just have to find her.
Fighting!
fighting in the capital? Ugh. And we're fighting against Edelgard. Double ugh. But with you leading us, Professor, I know we'll win. Yeah! Woohoo! Fighting! I'm a little scared, to be honest. I'm just shouting to relieve the tension, but I'll be fine.
I love to cook. What are we making today?
That's so.
I have a lot of experience in the kitchen. I can make just about anything. Wow.
Delicious food really takes my worries away.
This is so good. Can I have seconds?
Professor? Professor!
Here we have. I don't know.
Lady Rhea's not waiting for me.
There is still more to learn.
Turns up as a...
This one?
Thank you.
This one? This one?
Thank you.
This one? Thank you. This one? Thank you. This one? Thank you. This one? Thank you. This one? Thank you. This one? This one? Thank you. This one? Thank you. This one? Thank you. Please come again.
Well, I'll be. Just a few months ago, I thought it was impossible to secure a victory against the Imperial Army. But you've shown me miracles can happen after all. I believe that victory is within your grasp.
Hello there.
This one, yes. This one, yes. I, this one, yes. I, this one, yes. I thank you.
Return soon, please.
You really think I'm that great?
I'm feeling good about this.
Apply this knowledge.
Put in some effort, for once. Nothing to get excited about.
Let's not exaggerate.
There is always more to learn.
Huh?
No need to discontinue with the praises.
Hey, Professor, I got a question. Oh, wow, I get it now.
I was just thinking that I wanted to speak with you. A fresh and fruity aroma. Oh, yes, this is my kind of tea. Thank you. Settles nicely on the palate. Indeed.
Splendid.
Oh? I see. Oh? Indeed. I cannot yet speak to you as an equal, not when there is still so much left to learn. Wonderful. Next time, I will provide the tea. Farewell.
We won't even break a sweat. Right. No problem. We did a fine job.
Good fuel for a scheme.
I have much expertise now.
I'm starting to get it.
I've learned a thing or two from battle.
I'm finding my focus.
Thank you.
Unbelievable.
I did it! I did it! Okay, so next up is...
What's this letter all about? Doesn't appear to have a sender written anywhere. This handwriting is so sloppy. Wow. Dear Lysithia, I read the book you gave me. This must be from Cyril! He's learning so quickly! It was hard, and it got more easy, more I tried it, and it was fun, and I learned new stuff. That's the spirit. Thanks you for helping me to read and to write. You are so welcome. Some things are hard to say and easy to write. I know just what you mean. I want to read more and learn writing better. You're already doing so well with this. I can see how hard you're working. I am glad you are my friend. It makes me bappy. Aww.
Hey, Lysithia. Last night I finished reading the book you lent me. I wanted to tell you right away, but it was late, so I tried to write a letter. Lysithia?
Cyril! You sweet little...
Did I do something wrong? I don't know what you're trying to say.
Some feelings can't be verbalized or put into writing. Just... Look, it's just that...
I'm sorry. I really don't know what you're trying to say.
What I'm trying to say is... I'm bappy too.
But... Bappy?
Let's keep studying and spending time together, okay?
Oh, I get you now. That sounds great, Lysithia.
No.
Huh?
We're heading up there.
Yes? I thank you. This one, yes? This one, yes? I thank you.
Return soon, please.
Professor?
Professor!
Here we are. We have... I don't know.
Professor?
If he turns...
We must...
Lady Rails.
This is... This is what...
Please.
Yes.
I was to quest the clock. It is
indeed.
Capital is Adel.
My mother, I do not. I shall take it.
Now. This experience is critical. I just got... His focus.
Bye, Bridget, but I will so now.
There is still more to learn.
To this.
I've come. I must always improve.
Don't stop. Keep it coming. I'm glad I put in some effort, for once.
Professor?
I'm glad it's you.
I'm glad it's you! We did good out there!
There must be more to this.
I think I got it. All that work was worth it.
I'm finally grasping this.
Aha!
I passed, as expected.
All that hard work's paid off.
Thank you.
Oh yeah! Nailed it!
No.
Hey.
Huh?
We're heading up.
I'm getting the hang of this.
Professor!
Huh?
Not anything you'd call cuisine. I just think it's all the same once it's in your stomach, so why overdo it with the cooking, right? Oh, really?
To you two, I get to sit down and enjoy this tasty meal.
A meal you can eat while listening to Hilda praise you is a gift all its own. Right, Teach?
We're heading up.
Is this for me? It's so nice! Is this for me?
Professor?
Professor! Here we I don't know. Professor!
Oh, my.
For me?
Hmm.
Please.
I was to quest, but it is indeed. Oh my, this is lovely. Oh my, this is lovely.
Need something? See you again soon. Could I trouble you?
Hey.
Sir. Battle was. Battle will cease.
This is wonderful. This is wonderful.
His focus.
I could get used to this. Let's do this.
You really think I'm that great?
Perseverance is the key. Don't stop. Keep it coming.
That was helpful.
Hopefully this proves useful.
Let's not exaggerate.
Thank you. with you on my side, this'll be a cakewalk.
I'm glad it's you.
We did a fine job.
More cards for my sleeve. I am getting to the heart of it.
I'm really getting the hang of it.
Perseverance is the key.
I'm a quick study.
Making strides.
I always was a quick study.
It is necessary to be having fresh ingredients for cooking. One day, I will be showing you cooking from my homeland.
I am in agreement.
Smell. It's amazing. My fave, in fact. Do you like it too?
Eating delicious food really takes my worries away.
I don't know.
We must.
Hello there.
Lady Riz.
I need to be speaking.
The dead, I will. His focus.
I'm getting the hang of this.
got no time for mercy. You will regret this! You lost that one. No time for mercy. You're in my way! I will not die yet. Yet.
Hey there. Is this it? There you go. Come back anytime. Thank you.
After making preparations at Garrig Mach, the Alliance Army marches to Anbar, the Imperial capital. In response to the Alliance's movements, Emperor Edelgard orders her trusted retainer, Hubert, as well as the Death Knight, to the front lines to meet the Alliance army head-on. The two forces clash in the city streets.
There it is. Anbar. The Imperial capital and the largest city in all of Fodlan.
It's not just big. This city was designed to protect the castle where the Emperor lives. It's as though the city itself is a massive stronghold.
They surely noticed us approaching some time ago, and yet...
Our scouts confirm the citizens haven't been evacuated. They're being kept in town.
I've got to hand it to Her Imperial Majesty. Using her citizens as a shield to protect the castle takes some resolve.
I suspect those mages will be lurking within as well.
Troops deployed to other areas are also returning.
If we don't conquer the city quickly, things will get complicated fast.
We can't search until we conquer the city. Let's focus on the fight for now.
Lady Rhea, please be safe.
We've kept the Empire waiting long enough. Onward!
I choose to believe in my potential.
Thank you.
We were told Hubert would be leading the enemy forces, but the Death Knight's also with them. We'll have to take care of both of them, but we won't have time to mop up all the enemy units. We'll have to split up and take them on at the same time, or risk being overrun by their reinforcements.
It's here! The Crest of Flames banner! There, on the other side of the canal!
Uninvited guests, I see. Let's ensure they receive a warm welcome. Ready the artillery.
Prepare to attack. Rocks, arrows, magic. Rain death upon the enemy until they are silent as the grave. Reinforcements will fly in shortly. Defend the heavy weapons until they arrive.
I'll do my best.
What's my strategy?
At the ready.
My orders? Make a difference?
Hey, look at you!
Shall we?
There's no stopping me.
Steady now. I took care of it.
Practice is paying off.
Leave it to me. That's another one. Am I getting closer?
Let's make this quick.
Guide me well. That is all.
You lost that one. That helps. I've got no time for mercy.
Decent form.
close.
Destiny unfurls.
Seems I've improved again.
We still have a long way to go. To be done.
Just like that. This could turn the tides.
I'm sorry! I won, didn't I?
A predictable success.
Thank you. destroy you! For Geralt!
Judgment is past.
I won't allow it.
Feeds growth.
Our first wave of reinforcements is here. It'll not be long until the next.
Reinforcements? That was quick. We can't hang around or they'll just keep coming. We'll have to capture the artillery. We can turn them against their reinforcements.
I've been waiting for you.
So close.
more battles means more strength.
Curtsy.
I may not survive.
I'll use this power for the greater good.
Okay. Just Hubert left to deal with.
We are taking heavy losses. We need more troops.
Lament your weakness.
Apologies.
You defeat me? Left.
Had I room to grow?
Sorry, but it's you or me.
So close. Sorry, but I must.
Yeah!
Thank you, Spirit!
Oh.
Alright, who's next? Make a difference? Hopefully, I'll be more useful now.
We have reinforcements coming in from another direction. Deploy them as soon as they arrive.
Too easy.
No!
What's my strategy? chance.
There's a way forward. I'll try to put this to use.
I'm impressed.
Can't afford to slack off.
Grateful.
Sorry. Appreciate it. Ha! Piece of cake.
Lament your weakness.
Sorry, it's gotta be like this.
Thank you. believe I can do more. Thank you.
I'm grateful.
I'm sorry.
I must leave them well.
Fitting outcome.
Too easy. Appreciate that.
For the future of Bodlin.
I must continue my training.
no time to slow down. I'm not there yet.
Sorry, but I must. This still isn't good enough.
Sorry.
Been so long since I was in that opera house. Couldn't have imagined any of this back then. To be done. Yeah. no choice. Never let your guard down. I still have a long way to go.
Fun to watch.
Still got hidden talents.
Thank you.
Time for a secret scheme.
About a curtsy. I will not die yet. Can't afford to slack off.
Appreciate that.
Good, but not enough.
I'm sorry. You're too slow! Stay away! It's done.
survive!
Destiny unfurls.
I am so impressed.
Should have disposed of you a long time ago. I will rectify that failure here.
Sorry about that.
We're all desperate, aren't we?
Church. I've such memories of that place from a time before I was Seteth.
Well done.
Apologies.
I'm grateful.
survive.
Sorry, but it's you or me.
I'll try.
Oh, nice!
Yeah. I understand now.
No time to slow down.
Another victory. I'll use this power for the greater good.
Very helpful.
Perhaps. Shall we? Never let your guard down.
It's over, Lapdog. Your military rule is at its end.
For every step you take along that path, our thorns will cut into your heels.
Ooh, that sounds painful. I'll have to wear thicker soles for the march.
If your boots are too heavy, you won't be able to lift your feet. But enough prattle.
Strategy in motion!
We must place our faith in Her Majesty. Her victory is everything.
Well done, everyone. Now we can break through into Anbar. We need to hurry up and attack the palace to block Edelgard's movements. We've made it this far. Somehow. Edelgard is probably looking down on us from somewhere in that castle.
I wonder if she's panicking, or just smiling smugly.
From this point on, she'll be giving it her all, too. Expect her to be tougher than the last time we fought. This battle will settle things once and for all. We'll attack as soon as everyone is ready. Huh? Is that you, Dudu?
I heard the Alliance's army had entered the city. I've been searching for you ever since. I arrived not long after the battle at Gronder Field. I am here to kill Edelgard.
Well, if you want to fight alongside us, we'd be more than happy to have you.
We fight for different objectives. I swore to offer Edelgard's head to His Highness. But should I fail, I will have no choice but to entrust that mission to you. This is the information I have gathered during my time in hiding here. It includes details about the inside of the castle.
I appreciate this, but what do you plan to do? Don't tell me you plan to go alone.
I've done what I came here to do. Farewell.
Hey! Wait! He's gone. He's just as hard to understand as his liege was. The time has finally come, my friend. Once we win this fight, the Empire will fall. The subject is heavy on my mind. Odd as it sounds, I believe the forces responsible for destroying Fodlan are also responsible for protecting the livelihood of its citizens. Everything, even the land itself, has been harmed by the chaos of war. Restoring it will be no easy feat. To do that, the first thing we need to think about is a new ruling system for all of Fodlan. As usual, we're on the same page. I was thinking the same thing. Even if the Alliance lords and any remaining influential nobles were to divide up dominion of all of Fodlan, they would simply pursue their own interests. Another war would be inevitable. That's why there needs to be a powerful ruler who stands above them all and unifies Fodlan as one nation. A new ruler, huh? I think I've got someone in mind. My dreams await in a future where Fodlan is no longer ravaged by war. There are things I want to see with you someday. I'll keep thinking about the best way to achieve that goal. Whatever we decide to do, we can't do it until we defeat the Empire. Fodlan can't welcome a new dawn until we win the war. Let's prepare as best we can.